Today, I'm going to demystify grand center dispatch. I know it's a scary topic, you are afraid of threading and queuing, but today I'm going to show you how easy it is to work with grand center dispatch. So I'm Alex from Rebeloper.com, and if you are interested in that, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell, and let's dive in. Today, I'm going to demystify grand center dispatch and multi-threading. But before we do that, let me remind you about rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. If you have any Swift UI, Swift questions, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, I have prepared a demo project for this. It's called GCD demo, Grand Center Dispatch demo. And basically what this does, let me just build and run so you know that it's no big deal. I have a text right over here and two buttons, and I've used the MVV M model. I do have my view model right over here. I have two published variables, is background yellow and the data. Let's check out the is background color. So we can change the background color when we are tapping on this button. Basically, we are toggling the is background yellow state variable. Okay, so that's about it. Now, that is, of course, because you know that UI changes are on the main thread. That is done on the main thread, so it works exceptionally well. There are no delays, no waits. It's just changing the background color. Now, the other thing we have here is a fetch data. And on the view model, I have created this fetch data function. What it does is just kind of simulates slow internet connection, or maybe there's a large image to be downloaded. It's just waiting, sleeping for 4 seconds. And then we are going to add, we are going to get that data eventually, and that is this new string value, and we are going to add this string value to the published variable called data, which in turn will update the text on top. So let's see how this looks like right over here. But before I jump into the explanation, let's just talk a little about what Grand Central Dispatch is, because there's a lot of fuss about it, like multi-threading, queues, and all of that stuff. And I'm going to demystify for you this today, because it's really, really straightforward. And as I saw, developers are kind of scared about this. Well, you will not be scared anymore about Grand Center Dispatch. Well, as it turns out, the UI has to run on the main thread, so the user will not see any glitches, any waits in animation, or anything that might disturb the UI and the user experience. Now, that is always on the main thread, but of course you will have some large processing stuff inside your app. Let's say we are downloading a large image or processing a video, and that will be put on a background thread, on a background queue. So what we are going to do today is just teach you, I'm going to show you how you can do all of this. So first of all, let's see what this sleep does for our UI. So I'm going to build and run again, and change background color works, so it's on the main thread, and then fetching data. As you can see, if I tap, and of course you did not actually see that, but I tapped on the change background color, it just waited for those 4 seconds and only then changed our background. Also, the fetch data button was not tappable anymore, so it was kind of freezing the UI. And that's because this sleep for 4 seconds and the data change and setting the published variable data is all on the main thread, and it's just blocking it. Let's just see this in action. I have created a log right over here, so let's create, let's have some more space here. So I'm just going to go dispatch queue.log, and let's see, this is fetching data. Okay. And right over here, we are going to update the UI. So, updating UI. Great. Let's see what this log tells us. So I'm building and running again. Let's just wait for that build has succeeded. Tapping on fetch data. And now you see we are fetching the data on the main thread. And after 4 seconds, again on the main thread, we are updating the UI. Now, because this takes a little bit more time than expected, so it's a large computation, then we want to move this onto a background thread. Well, actually, we want to move it away from the main thread so users might interact with your UI further. So what we need to do is just go on a background thread. And how do we do that? Well, we just go dispatch queue.main. And we are going to use the async, and there is also an async, the global. I just thought that about main, but I'm correcting myself. We need to have the global, and there are a global quality of service options. If you don't know what that is, then you won't need to know. All you need to know is that if you don't provide it, it will just use the default value. Otherwise, there is background. Let's just take a look at this. So, for example, we have background, utility, default, unspecified, and user initiated. Now, all of these are going to be not the main thread. So, and you can just Google what these are specifically are. Basically, it starts with the user interactive, and as we go deeper till the background, that's the queue that has the deepest level of background queue. So let's just go with background, why not? And we are going to use async, and we are going to add this code right over there. And by the way, let's just move also this log into our background dispatch queue. So we will see that, okay, what is being printed out? Let's fetch data. As you know, you can see it's a background fetching data on the background and background updating UI. Well, that's not good because the UI has to be updated on the main thread. So what do we do? Well, most probably you are familiar with this. And yes, this is where the main thread comes in, what I typed in earlier. So dispatch queue.main.async. And I'm going to move these two lines right over there. So let's remove these spaces and let's build and run. And now you will see that we are fetching the data and the UI is not actually being blocked. As you can see, I could change the background of our view. Furthermore, the fetching of data was on the background queue and updating UI is now on the main queue. So it's a main thread. This is really, really important because UI has to be done, UI changes have to be done on the main thread, and changing the data will change that text as you already know. Now, basically that's all you have to know about dispatch queue and the grant center dispatch. Global quality of services, main queue. There's one little more as a bonus. I will just give you this one. There's also dispatch queue.main and async after. So let's take a look at what this actually does. So there's a deadline. So we can just go and have dot now and plus, we can just go seconds or we could just use two. So after 2 seconds, we are going to execute this. So let's just print out after 2 seconds. And let's see what happens right now inside the logs. So we just go fetching data. So fetching data, and then it says after 2 seconds. And after that, we are updating the UI on the main thread, of course, because we did get our data from the server or whatever. Now that is all about Grant Center Dispatch. Now, if you are interested of my top 10 GitHub repositories that I recommend for iOS developers, go ahead and check out the video right over there. I will see you in that one.